What are you talking about?
It's called making money in furniture. I've been thinking now, I've got to stop that.
I'm thinking I'll get you in trouble every time.
So what's this initial phase called, Brian?
It's just called the drawing stage. I'm starting to block in the shadows here too. Breaking it down into light and dark patterns. And the next stage I'll do, sometimes I start with the light and go to the dark, he's mostly in the, mostly I have the side that's toward the light, so I don't have as much shadow, but there's different systems that I use that start with the darkest darks and then go up to the lightest lights. But I may go and start with the lights on this one. So that's where I am right now. So far, so good. Part of that is going to the half tones. Like I would start with the dark and then go to the middle tones and then the lights and then the highlights. But, it doesn't always follow that exactly. This lighting that we have on him is what's almost called a Rembrandt lighting. If you look at portraits of Rembrandt, they always have this sort of triangle in the cheek, and it's caused just by the way he set them up. It's what's sort of known today as Rembrandt lighting. Stick. It's a stick to steady my hand, but I have to bring it today.
Why do you put your paint on tinfoil?
It's something I started using a long time ago, and then when I get it filled up, I just take it off the palette and throw it away. But I took a class with Kinsler, and he thought it was just horrible. He said, you had to get rid of that tinfoil.
Everett
Raymond Kinsler, yeah. But when you work outside, it creates a lot of reflections, and I guess that was his qualm with it. So next I'm going to go switch to, I've got the drawing pretty well done, I'm going to switch to the painting part of it here. Surely once I get the right brush out. What they say is you should use the largest brush possible.